Hey, what's up guys, let's create this cool animation in After Effects using Puppet Pin Tools and Duik Angela. If you don't know basics of Puppet Pin Tool, then I would recommend to watch the previous video of the series and then continue with this. And if you don't have Duik Angela already installed in your computer, then make sure you install it. We have a dedicated video for the Duik Angela. The link is in the description below. So let's start with the new composition. Meanwhile, make sure you already subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon next to it, because if you're not doing that, then you're going to miss a lot of exciting notifications for all our future uploads. So I have this BG image. I've got it from the free pick. I'll put the link of the free pick in the description below. Let me just zoom out a little bit and scale it down to fit my composition. And now to add a background color, let's create a new solid. I have selected this nice blue color. You can select whichever you want for your background based on your assets. Let's just move this at the bottom. And now we need to bring in our character. So I already have created this PNG again from the free pick. I'll put the link for this character image as well in the description. So you can download this character from free pick and just get a PNG inside After Effects. If you want to use any other character, feel free to do that, because this tutorial is not specifically for the characters or for the assets. It's more or less to understand the workflow with Puppet Pin Tool and Duik Angela. Okay, so let's just align this here on the ground and let me scale it down a little bit so this looks nice in the background. Okay, this is good. And guys, sorry, I have a lot of panels here in the After Effects, but unfortunately I cannot use my both screens to record the videos. That's why I have to put everything here for your reference. And let's just quickly go to the Puppet Pin Tool here, and let's select the position pin, and let's add a couple of pins for the tail. Don't worry, you can just put random number of pins based on the character you are using. So here I am using a tail, so I want a nice wavy movement. So I have just created multiple puppet pins here. And just to make sure that our character is not wobbling or moving along with these pins, let's add some position pins here as well on the four corners. And then we also want to rotate the head as well. So I'll use advanced puppet pin tool so we can adjust the rotation and the position in a single pin. And if you don't know what are the uses of these different pins, as I already mentioned, make sure you watch the previous video of the series and then follow along with this, because then you will understand use of each and every pin in the After Effects. Okay, so now we are done with all our puppet pinning jobs. So now let's quickly select all these pins here. The reason of selecting this is, if you do it without selecting, then Duik Angela will add pins to all the pins here we have, but we don't want to do this. We just want to control our tail only with the Duik Angela. So that's why I have selected the pins which I want, and then I'll go to the link tab of the Duik Angela. So you can see these are different tabs. So just go to the link tab of the Angela and then click on add pins. So it will basically create the pins as per our selected pin. So now you can see it has created all these pins which we have created here in the After Effects. Let me just deselect everything first, and then make sure you select the pin from the last to the first. So I'm selecting it from the top to bottom, and this order is important because based on the selection, then Duik Angela will be adding a control layer, which is the next step. So to add a control layer, again we are in the same links and the constraints tab, and here in the kinematics you can select FK. FK is forward kinematics, IK is inverse kinematics. If you don't know what is IK and FK, then I would recommend you first understand that. FK is basically when you move the first joint, all other joints will automatically adjust with it, and IK is basically you can do individual movements of each bone. And in characters, mostly we use FK, which is forward kinematics, and I have just selected the FK, and now you can see it has created one more layer here, which is controller. Okay, so you can change the icon color and all from the controller section of the effects here. Let's make this probably yellow or white so we can just see it here. And yeah, that's it. So let's just add the rotation. So I'm selected the character pin. Now you can simply hide all these Now you can simply hide all these pins here. We don't need them. So I have just selected the controller and I have opened the rotation property. I'll just quickly add a keyframe here. Move a couple of frames in the timeline and now rotate the tail. And let's rotate it back. And I'll copy the first keyframe to the last. And when I play this animation, you can see it is just adding it into RAM preview, but you can see my tail is automatically animated with just 4 keyframes and everything is handled. You can see the follow through of the tail. Everything is handled by the Duik Angela and the puppet pins. So we don't need to do a lot of hassles here. And if you don't want to see all these layers in the timeline as well, you can just simply hide them with the Shy tool. So I'll just select the Shy and I'll just, you know, click here. So all the layers which are toggled in for the Shy are hidden. And now you can just focus on the layers which you want to work on. So I'll select the character layer and I'll go to the pin tool again. Or you can simply select the puppet here in the effect panel. And now you would be seeing all these pins here which we have created on the character. I'll select the pin which we have created for the head, and by default After Effects enable the stopwatch for the puppet pin, so we don't need to add it manually. Let's just move a couple of frames along with the tail and just move it a little bit. You know, you can exaggerate based on your requirements. And I'll just move a little forward here. I'll just move the neck all the way to the round. And now while selecting the character layer, I'll just hit U on the keyboard, which will show me all the keyframes which I have. I'll just adjust the distance here. I'll select the first keyframe. I'll move a couple of frame forward where my animation is, or my tail is getting back to the original position. And I'll just paste it. So all our animation is started and syncing up very well. And now it is settled down. And just to make sure you have, you know, nice and smooth curves in the animation, you can select all the keyframes here and you can apply any motion curve here. So let's apply this simple S curve or ease in ease out curve to all the keyframes. By the way, this plugin is Flow, which is a cool time saver plugin for the animation curves. So now you can see our animation is ready, and do let me know in the comments if you have enjoyed this or not. And yep, till the next video, keep watching, keep learning, keep designing.